resident. But still, we wanna, increase their recycling.
Yeah, still, we're still, you know, we're good, but we're not what we need to be.
Well, and the bar is being lifted.
And the bar is great.
Well, one of the things we talked about last time, and Steve was here, meeting outside, is what if we had a no bag, no bin, no barrel program? And his response was, is there's not many bag barrels. He picks up that there isn't a recycle bin next to it. And, you know, I drove around the town and look at things, and he's probably right. You see a lot of recycle, only, and whenever there's a bin out there, there's usually about the...
At least one.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think Jamestowners are pretty cognizant of...
Well, only 24% though, we're not that cognizant.
Well, yeah, you're right. They put them out, but they must put stuff in those, in their garbage.
Right.
That's the problem.
They do.
Are there recycle bins down by the ferry, the dock down there in town? Are there recycle?
We don't maintain, I don't know whether CMS does, Connecticut Marine Services. I think they have something that, you know, that applies to their customers.
But you're saying if there's waste fast, there's waste containers down there that we can't count in as residential?
Right, yeah, that's, yeah, not household.
And what's collected by the Jamestown Litter Corps is not counted as residential?
Well, my druthers on this, and you've probably known this all along, but I really like the find the bags and having them. Because I really think if each person had to buy the bags, it wouldn't put as many recyclables in those bags. It would turn out to be garbage in those bags, and it would create more recyclables in the bins. And the problem is working out how we work that out.
How to make that work.
And I am very much, I really think island rubbish has to be our vehicle. They're so part of this community that we just can't, you know, not have them do it. But I just was, I kept thinking about how we could have that.
And the bag and tag part, or page is wrote, I certainly think, you know, a private hauler that's done in many communities can be operate under a contract with the community that requires that they only pick up refuse that is in compliance with the page is wrote. Particularly that there actually was an opportune time going into the end of the contract with rubbish. Not that I think they would, you know, would modify a contract to move towards that type of system, but given the fact that we are going to be bidding out the that assignment next year, we could write into it that these are the rules, that your customers got to have, you know, whatever, you know, page and throw system you have in place, and that they, as the collector, are charged with monitoring that, and that anybody who's not complying, that they cannot pick up their trash. And they, Steve has expressed to me before, he said, gee, then we get to be the bad guy. Irritate my customer, which is not a good public relations.
But he just says that to the town.
Yeah, in fact, the town will say, you know, make public pronouncements that this is the mandate, you know, that we're imposing on any person who's collecting trash, whether it's waste management or island rubbish or anybody. So I think we take that concern, wipe that concern away.
Right.
But yeah, I think that option, if you would continue the split system of transfer station and private subscription service through the curbside collection. From a managerial standpoint, you can work that out. It's the economics piece in terms of, okay, let's say we're if people have to buy these bags, are they, well, how does that, what's that mean with respect to what they're already paying and other taxes, if that's covering disposal or tipping fee costs, whether it's already, tipping fees are already in the town budget, how do we assure the voters that they're not getting whacked twice?
We talked about having a town-wide pickup and the transfer station being used for the batteries, the computers, and all of that, and that everyone would have, be able to have, you know, pick up. But again, it would all go on our taxes, I guess, rather than $100 fees or we charge everybody a certain fee.
If you have a peso requires that somebody pay out of their private pockets, you know, for the banks, because that's
right.
Where the economic incentive comes
from. Right.
And so, and it has to be, as was discussed several meetings back, that's going to be of significant magnitude in terms of that pricing to make it affect behavior. Maybe 2 cents per bag.
Right.
A buck or more bags go out, or even more than that.
Right.
So then that's where we'll say, well, okay, what's that covering cost up? Obviously, it's not just the bag. The bag doesn't cost the buck a bag. It's costing something else.
He told us last
week. Typically. You know,
last week, or sometimes 14 cents a bag.
Right. So you're finding in other numbers into that.
We still have the dilemma. If pile of rubbish picks up 100% and we charge people for bags, the average person will be paying $144 versus the $288 they're paying today to have Island Rubbish pick up the trash. So they're getting a big deal, a good deal. The town would have to make up the difference to keep Island Rubbish in business, and you'd get that from the revenue you got from the bags. Mm-hmm. But it may not be enough. You might have to raise the price of the bags every now and then, whatever. But the transfer station people would be paying $144.
No, we would eliminate. If the whole town, they still buy bags. They still buy bags.
And if they buy 8 bags, it's $144, and today they're paying $100.
Right.
So it's a great deal for the people who are subscribing to Island Rubbish right now. They would pin medals on your chest. However, mm-hmm. the people from the transfer station wouldn't like you very much.
Mm-hmm.
You'd have a very exciting town meeting.
More
exciting.
Maybe that should be something that we should put to the town, put to the residents. You know, in one of our articles, what would your solution be? The town has to do this. What is some of your, you know, a bigger fish tank might give you more input.
They would think of their own personal situation.
Which is okay, because sometimes you can get ideas from that.
And they would say, I don't want to pay any more.
Right now, it costs $145,000 for the transfer station.
Increased recycling. What would be some of your ideas?
Because you've got 95, you've got the 15 to haul.
You've got the 35 to haul. No matter what we do, we're not going to.
Right? $145. So, and there are 1,000 people
in the note.
And you're hungry. And that's only. So that's getting it closer, isn't it, to the
But we'd have to lower the transfer station fee to zero for the people who are using it, and they'd still be paying more. So the town would then have to subsidize the transfer station if you kept it open. I suspect if Island Rubbish picked up 100% of the town, the transfer station would only have to be open one day a week to get scrap metal and televisions and that sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And you wouldn't need a person up there all the time, and you wouldn't have the hauling fees that you have today. However, you'd probably still have some.
Mm-hmm.